everybody around you feel like hell. When I left, I was young. I had a young kid's point of view on my father. So when I was 22 at 300 pounds, I went back to see my dad. Because I wanted to make sure that what I saw at 8 is the same vision, because it's my father. I don't want to not talk to my father, no matter what he did, no matter what I saw, but was it through a young kid's eyes? Mm-hmm. So at 22, I went back. And I was able to examine him as a man, as a fragile man that I was.
Sure.
But I was able to examine him. And by this point in my life, I was examining myself and realizing I have a whole mess of problems, big time. Some were from him, some were from people that bullied me, a lot were from me. And in knowing how messed up I was able to examine everybody around me. I examined him. And I examined him to know, my God, the insecurities that you must have, the problems that you must have inside of you, I don't want to have those. I come from my father. I have what he has. And I didn't want to be him. Why he made fun of me, my brother, why he beat the hell out of me, my brother, my mom. It comes from a dark place. An insecure, dark, dark place. Why he womanized, why he sold prostitutes, why he ran all this stuff he did. A good human being doesn't need to do that. A fulfilled human being doesn't need to break anyone down. All they do is want to build you up. So anybody you meet that calls you out of your name, that bullies you, that messes you up, that makes you feel not lifted, they are dealing with something deep-rooted. Yeah, you have to have a tough tone with some people to help them out. There's a difference. You have to be hard. I'm hard on people, but it comes from a good place.
Yeah.
The biggest lesson he taught me was how not to be. And that's why I had to fix what I was. Because insecurities make everybody around you feel like hell. And that's the one thing I did not want anyone to feel like. That's why I judge no one. Tons of whites have called me nigger. Tons of people have hurt me. I judge no one. Mental toughness isn't something that you sample. It's something that you live in every day.